Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, curious, curious minds. We're back yet with another video for you to quench your thirst for all things space. So buckle right in because we're going on a flight to the stars. But before we move on, make sure to press that subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss out on any of our latest space niche videos. In this video, we'll be bringing you up to date with the recent developments in the crazy world. Can you call it that? Crazy world of... I mean, come on. Yeah, the crazy world of space. Today, we're talking about Elon Musk helping rival company OneWeb to launch their satellites into space. Both firms are building constellations in the sky to deliver broadband internet connections. While SpaceX can send up its Starlink system using its own rockets, OneWeb was left looking for rides when the Ukraine war forced it to abandon the use of Russian Soyuz vehicles. OneWeb has now contracted SpaceX. On March 21st, 2022, in London, United Kingdom, OneWeb, the low Earth orbit LEO satellite communications company, announced today that the company and SpaceX entered into an agreement that will enable OneWeb to resume satellite launches. This historic moment took place after the British company, OneWeb, was refused by Russia to let it use its rockets to launch the satellites. OneWeb turned to Musk and got the help they needed to send its internet beaming satellites into orbit. Even though the terms of this rather unusual deal weren't disclosed, it's obvious that the two competitors coming together must mean that they're working on something bigger than their competition. It's hoped that the first of the series of launches can take place before the end of the year. The tensions between OneWeb and Russia rose when the company was forced to call off its scheduled March 4th launch of 36 satellites on one of Russia's Soyuz rockets after Russia's space agency, Roscosmos, demanded a guarantee that the technology would not be used for military purposes and the British government sold its stake in the company. Of course, the United Kingdom declined these terms and rejected all calls from Russia, and the timing of the cancellation wasn't great either. The launch cancellation came amid heightened tensions between Russia and NATO governments, including Britain, over economic sanctions imposed against Moscow by the West in response to Russia's February 24th invasion of Ukraine. We recall the company, OneWeb, was rescued from bankruptcy by the British government and Indian telecoms giant Bharti Global in 2020 when the UK was seeking a post-Brexit alternative to the EU's satellite navigation system, Galileo. The UK government took a £400 million stake in OneWeb in July of 2020, investing to save the business from bankruptcy when it failed to secure funding in March that year to continue building out its planned fleet of 650 satellites. With the Soyuz rocket off of the table, there were a few other launch options for OneWeb, which is headquartered in London and partly owned by the UK government. Europe has no spare launch capacity, with all of its remaining Ariane 5 launches spoken for. Meanwhile, the Ariane 6 rocket is probably at least 2 years away from having operational capacity. Last October, OneWeb and India Space Program, ISRO, reached an agreement to use Indian rockets for future satellite launches, but these rockets have not demonstrated a high launch cadence. Japan's H2A rocket was also considered, but it too lacks significant capacity. That left SpaceX, the only Western company with excess launch capacity for medium lift missions in the near term. Nevertheless, the relationship between both the firms seems to be a promising one. As OneWeb CEO Neil Masterson in his recent address says, "We thank SpaceX for their support, which reflects our shared vision for the boundless potential of space. With these launch plans in place, we're on track to finish building out our full fleet of satellites and deliver robust, fast, secure connectivity around the globe." SpaceX has more than 2,000 satellites in its Starlink system orbit, although it's following a different architecture from OneWeb, which is much lower in the sky. Every week or so, the Hawthorne, California-based company adds to its network by sending up yet another batch of Starlinks on one of its reusable Falcon rockets. Contracting with SpaceX to use the Falcon vehicle was really the only near-term option for OneWeb. With the withdrawal of Soyuz from the international market because of sanctions, there's now a dearth of rockets in the class that can send up batches of satellites in the way required in OneWeb's business plan. The first launch with SpaceX is anticipated in 2022 and will add to OneWeb's total in-orbit constellation that currently stands at 428 satellites, or 66% of the fleet. OneWeb's network will deliver high-speed, low-latency global connectivity. The company quotes a standard price of $67 million to launch a Falcon 9 rocket, up to $62 million earlier this year, to account for excessive levels of inflation. The 12% increase is the first in nearly 6 years. Although SpaceX and OneWeb are both pursuing the same goal, a broadband internet from the sky, they're targeting, in the first instance, somewhat different sectors. Whereas SpaceX will sell connection terminals direct to the consumer, OneWeb is focused instead on selling its connections to telcos. These partners would then offer the OneWeb system to customers as part of their package of internet solutions. OneWeb was launching 34 to 36 satellites at a time on the Soyuz rocket. The spacecraft was held at the top of the vehicle to be deployed in space by a structure called a dispenser. This hardware will need to be adapted to work on the Falcon. Demand for OneWeb's broadband connectivity services has continued to grow across telecommunications providers, aviation and maritime markets, and governments worldwide. OneWeb has activated service with its network at the 50th parallel and above, and early partners are initiating service. Neil Masterso's decision also underscores the reality that Russia's invasion of Ukraine is having a devastating impact on the giant country's space industry. No Western nation is likely to do business with Russia in space for a long time, and that will leave SpaceX, with its reusable Falcon 9 and excess launch capacity, in a stronger position. This all comes 20 years after SpaceX CEO Elon Musk visited Russia in order to purchase a repurposed ICBM to launch the Mars Oasis project. Russia's rejection of Musk is part of what spurred him to found SpaceX. Now, 2 decades later, Musk is the one selling rockets to the rest of the world. What a flip. Even though OneWeb did not disclose how soon its SpaceX launch would happen, how many satellites it would deploy, which SpaceX launch vehicle would be used, or whether the deal includes more than one launch. SpaceX's Starlink has already put some 1,500 satellites in operation. Is it 1,500? It's 1,500. Yeah, 1,500 satellites in operation, including in war-torn Ukraine, providing internet access to regions underserved or hard to reach for other services. We know that SpaceX is one of the most successful firms in the business, and Musk's company can save OneWeb from facing the doom they faced back in 2020. And while SpaceX has started rolling out its Starlink service to customers in the United States and other countries, OneWeb is still primarily in the testing phase with its constellation. Congrats on having a great attention span. I know I talk a lot. Let us know how excited you are about the new ventures of SpaceX down in the comments below. We'll catch you there. And thanks for watching. And if you enjoyed the video, again, make sure to give us just a little like and subscribe for similar content. We'll catch you on the next one, Voyager.